Welcome to this screencast from LSE Life on creating a research plan. If you haven't done so yet, you may also want to check out our screencast on planning a week of your research. These two sessions are designed to work together to help you create a comprehensive plan to complete your master's dissertation successfully and on time. This session will take you through the seven steps you can follow to make your dissertation planning a success. Step 1, mark your immovable deadlines first. Step 2, block out any unavailable dates and times. Step 3, set your milestones. Step 4, set a date to start writing and keep to it. Step 5, take breaks. Step 6, review regularly. And step 7, allow contingency time. But first, if you haven't done so yet, please download the Dissertation Monthly Planner from this Moodle page. We will fill this in as you work through the slides. Okay, step 1, deadlines. With any successful planning, you need to start with your non-negotiables first. Your biggest non-negotiable is the hand-in deadline. Pause this video now and put a big cross on your hand-in day. All the planning you do now can work backwards from this date. It is a good idea to also set your own deadline earlier than the hand-in deadline, so you have some time to spare should you need it. So pause the video again and create your own deadline before this hand-in and mark this on the planner. We've suggested roughly an extra week, but you know your own working style better than anyone. So this earlier deadline could be a few days or a couple of weeks. Whatever you decide though, do not leave the deadline as your hand-in day. The dissertation is a long process and inevitably you will need more time for things than you think. Step 2, unavailable dates. Are there dates when you will be unavailable? Even while most countries are in lockdown, it is important to give yourself time off during the dissertation process to prevent burnout, even if that's just the commitment not to work at weekends. So again, pause this video now and black out your unavailable times on your planner. Step 3, set milestones. How do you know if your project is falling behind? Well, all effective planning needs good milestones. Milestones equals dates when you will have completed key elements of your dissertation. Milestones are personal and they will vary depending on the research you are doing. We've given you some example milestones here. Your milestones will, of course, vary depending on the nature of your research. First, if you haven't done so yet, please download the Dissertation Milestones worksheet from this Moodle page. Setting milestones for your work is almost as important as setting a deadline, so it is important to take some time to think these through properly. These need to be related to your work. Of course, you can use the examples on the last slide to help your thinking, but remember, not all of them will be relevant to everyone's research. Pause this video now and think about your milestones and then add these onto your milestone worksheet. Then, once you are happy with them all, you can begin adding these milestones to your plan. Remember, these should be big things, so they should be things such as complete bibliography by and not read article by. These can change, and probably will as your dissertation evolves, so you can add more and take away milestones as you work. Step 4, start writing. Actually, beginning to write your dissertation is incredibly easy to keep putting off. You may always have the feeling, if I just did a little more research, or if I just read this article, or if I just ran this analysis one more time. These feelings are perfectly normal, but they prevent you from getting started, and the longer you wait to get started, the more rushed the writing process will become. Writing is a thinking process, so writing a rough version will help you formulate ideas and know what you need to work on. This version will then change and evolve with each revision, and this is undoubtedly a good thing. So now pause the video again and add into your plan a milestone, the date to start writing. Step 5, take breaks. This is even more important now. Even if you are socially isolating, you should not aim to work every day. When you do take breaks, try to do something that doesn't involve a screen, such as reading a book for pleasure and not for your dissertation. Don't forget to take exercise outside, even for a short walk, if the country you are in allows it. And if you can't exercise outside, there are many free exercise videos on YouTube you could follow. So again, pause the video now and add at least one day off into your schedule. And remember to stick to it. You can and should add more later on. Step 6, review regularly. True time management requires a continual investment from you. For most people, it is unrealistic to expect organising your time once will result in always being organised. This is why it is important to monitor your actions and continually make changes and adjustments as and when you need it. So factoring into your weekly schedule 30 minutes or an hour each week to review that schedule and adjust where needed is much more effective than trying to work to the same plan each week. You also won't get it right first time, so be kind to yourself. And if your first plan doesn't work as well as you thought it would, note what happened and then make adjustments to the plan for the following week. Good planning involves anticipating problems and coming up with solutions. What possible issues could you have in doing your dissertation? We've given you some examples here. Now, more than ever, in the current global situation, it is clear that we need to be prepared for things to suddenly change. So pause your video now and add into your plan time each week to review your planning and make changes. Step 7, allow a little contingency time. Good planning also involves adding a little extra contingency for when things may go wrong. An extra day or half a day to your plan for each milestone can equal more time for something else if you finish earlier. Pause the video again now and look at some of the plans you've made so far. As you can continue to fill in the planner, allow a little extra time than you think activities will take. Then, if you don't use that time, you've got an added bonus of some spare time to work on something else. So let's recap. The 7 steps to successful dissertation research were: mark your removable deadlines first, then block out any unavailable times and dates, set your milestones, i.e. the key elements you must complete to reach your goal, set a date to start writing and keep to it, take breaks, review your plans regularly, and allow some contingency time. Good luck with your research and the writing of your dissertation, and remember, if you keep reviewing your plans regularly, you'll be able to manage this period a lot more successfully.